Lord, we proclaim you now of your mighty, oh Jesus, and your awesome majesty. Sing, Lord, Lord, come upon us and release,
and release your
letter. Jesus, unto you shall all flesh come. Your word says, behold, I'm the Lord, the God of all flesh, including all of us. Is there anything too hard for you? There is nothing too hard for you, God. We have gathered here because of the name Jesus that carries power, that is lifted above every name. I'm not here to entice anybody with my words. I'm here to speak your word. You know that which we need. So Jesus, take my body out and let your spirit begin to reign. Satisfy every soul. Let everybody live your place. And at the end of the day, they will not see mercy, they will see the name Jesus. And all glory be given to you. Shout a louder amen.
Amen.
Oh, shout a louder amen.
Amen.
Shout a louder amen.
Amen.
Turn to your neighbor, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Today is Mother's Day.
Mother's
God bless you. For wisdom,
for wisdom,
for understanding,
for knowledge,
to continue the good work you are doing in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Today climax the Women's Week, the 3 days Women's Week. Today is the final day, and the Lord is still working. And I believe your coming here will never be something you regret. But you always love God for being part of today's program. Say amen. I want us to read something. Before that, I want to say a very big thank you to my lovely husband. He has been so good and supportive. God bless you so much. You are looking very wonderful. You are looking very special. All of us, we love you. I salute you. Because you love God. You saw that way God has in me, and you decided to push me. So I will never forget you. I love you, and I say love to you. Everybody clap unto the Lord for the life of this man. Amen. Say, I am not condemned. Because Jesus never condemned me. Oh, you didn't say it to her. Say it with all boldness and confidence. Say, I am not condemned. Because the giver of life, the righteous man, he never condemned me. So I believe I am somebody. Say, even with all my sins, now I know Jesus. And I know in my heart that nobody can condemn me. Because the Savior never condemned me. Amen. Let us take the Bible and read something from John chapter 8, verse 1 to 11. I believe that the movement will cease. I want to read from the NLT. A woman caught in adultery. Jesus returned to the Mount of Olives. But early the next morning, he was back again at the temple. A crowd soon gathered, and he sat down and taught them. 3. As he was speaking, the teachers of religious law and the Pharisees brought a woman. Say, they brought a woman. Who had been caught in the act of what? Adultery. They put her in front of the crowd. 4. Teacher, they said to Jesus, This woman was caught in the act of what? Adultery. The law of Moses says to stone her. What do you say? 6. They were trying to trap him into saying something they could use against him. But Jesus stooped down and wrote in the dust with his finger. They kept demanding an answer. So he stood up again and said, all right, but let the one who has never sinned throw the first stone. Then he stooped down again and wrote in the dust. When the accusers heard this, they slipped away one by one, beginning with the oldest, until only Jesus was left in the middle of the crowd with the woman. Then Jesus stood up again and said to the woman, where are your accusers? Didn't even one of them condemn you? 11. See chapter verse 11. No, Lord, she said. And Jesus said, neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more. And Jesus said, neither do I. Go and sin no more. Say, neither do I. Go and sin no more. Hallelujah. The theme for our 3 days program is neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more. This is something I have been pondering about. I was telling Pastor that whenever I want to talk to people concerning the things of God, I want the Holy Spirit to use me to tell the people what God wants them to hear. Love making can never be one person. So that which existed didn't, it wasn't only the woman who did it. But the name of the man was not mentioned. Only the woman. They accused only the woman. And by then, what is law? Tells everybody, and everybody knows. That when you are a married woman, and you go to sleep with another man, you have to stone you to what?
Dead.
So then the people decided to take the woman to Jesus, the Savior. And when they went, they were trapping the Lord, trying to see what Jesus would say. They were still demanding an answer from Jesus. That this one, we saw it. She has done it. What should we do? At times, it's good not to answer very fast. Because the moment you give an answer very fast, you make mistakes. You have to think. So Jesus, he's not like man. Man can do something. And another man can give you instant justice. Nowadays, back home in Ghana, not only in Ghana, in Africa. If you steal, and you are caught, instant justice, they will give it to you. But when they took the woman to Jesus, everybody was expecting him. Because he is the owner of the law. So they told the woment they get there, Jesus will say, kill her. But the Savior was patient. He didn't look at anybody's face. He was just writing. What he was writing, only he knows. And the people were still demanding an answer. The Pharisees. We know Jesus to be our Savior. And now the woman has sinned. So what should we do? If you are a Savior and someone has sinned, they brought the person to you. Now you are a Savior. Somebody has sinned. The person is here. It is your law. So they were waiting for him to go against the law of the country, to use that of Moses' law. But he was very smart. And he's not like man. So he was just writing. When he lifted his head, everybody was gone.
Iedereen was weg.
Only the woman was there.
Alleen de vrouw was overgebleven.
Then he asked the woman,
where
are your accusers?
Waar zijn die veroordelers?
The people who said they saw you. Where are your accusers?
Waar zijn ze nu?
They were nowhere to be found.
Ze waren nergens te vinden.
Then Jesus said,
en toen zei Jezus,
if they are nowhere to be found,
ze nergens te vinden
then neither do I.
Ga in.
Neither do I, the Savior.
Ga ik de redder.
I will not condemn you.
Ook niet veroordelen.
But do what?
Maar
go and sin no more.
Ga en ga niet meer zondigen.
That is something I want us to take something from.
En dat is iets waar ik wil dat we iets uit
opnemen. I will not talk much.
Ik zal niet veel spreken.
But I want you to understand
maar
something.
Ik wil dat u iets gaat begrijpen.
In life.
In het leven.
Women.
Vrouwen.
We go through a lot.
We gaan door heel veel.
A mother.
Een moeder.
Can work.
Kan werken.
The fingers to bones.
Met haar vingers.
To take care of the children.
Zodat ze voor haar kinderen.
The child will only go and marry.
En die kind zal alleen gaan trouwen.
And another woman
en een andere vrouw
will tell
zal zeggen
the son
tegen die zoon
that your mother
dat je moeder
is a witch.
Een heks is.
Women, we accuse our own selves.
Vrouwen, wij veroordelen elkaar.
Women, we are our own enemies.
We zijn onze eigen vijanden.
When a woman married,
wanneer een vrouw trouwt,
and the husband is being stubborn,
die man is stubborn.
You look for your husband, you don't find him. You talk to him, he snubs you. If you can follow him step by step, you will meet your man in another woman's room.
Dat zult u een man.
Are we not our own enemies?
In een andere vrouw's kamer zijn we niet onze eigen vijanden.
You can work in a certain office.
Je kunt werken op een bepaalde kantoor.
You have not done anything to anybody.
Helemaal niets tegen iemand.
But the first person to hate you,
de eerste persoon om je te haten,
will be a woman.
Zal een vrouw zijn.
You go to work, you are not happy.
Je gaat naar het werk, je bent niet blij.
Why?
Waarom?
At times even in churches it's too happy.
Soms gebeurt het ook in kerken.
When you know God has been good to you, you have your better shoe, you have your better dress, you want to put it on to go and bless the Lord. Another woman in the house of the Lord will see your dressing and do, then your spirit is gone. If today, women, we begin to love ourselves, the Lord will not condemn us. Oh, shout and believe it, amen. There are many women in Europe.
Er zijn vele vrouwen in Europa.
They travel.
Ze hebben gereisd.
And even what to eat.
En zelfs wat ze moeten eten.
Very difficult.
Is heel moeilijk.
But they're able to save money.
Maar ze kunnen geld sparen.
And go to bring their husbands.
En hun mannen brengen.
And you see in Europe.
En in Europa.
Because of the changes in the weather.
Vanwege.
There are some things you cannot do. You give birth, your mother is not there. You want to take care of yourself. So even to do your hair daily, it is a problem. When the man comes, as a woman, you prepare. You buy him beautiful things. You look at yourself in the mirror. Because once he's here back in Africa, you were sending him money. So you look nice. When he gets here and he sees you, he thinks you're an old woman. Many women are dead and gone because of what some people, especially men, do to them. Oh, clap unto the Lord. Two people went to sleep. The name of the man was not mentioned. Why did they only have to take the woman? If Jesus had not intervened, the woman would have been stoned to death. There are many laws that goes against women. But today I'm here to announce to you that the Savior of our life, the giver and taker of life, he says he will not condemn you. So nobody condemn you. Nobody can condemn you. And you don't have to condemn yourself. And you don't have to accept condemnation from anybody. So I am not condemned.
Amen.
He has taken the shame. He has taken the pain that you are going through. Jesus has taken them all. So if they are accusing you, don't be worried at all. At times you can have your own property.
Soms heeft u uw eigen.
You want to be a blessing to your own sister.
U wilt de zegening zijn voor uw eigen zus.
This is my house.
Dit dit is mijn huis.
I'm not there.
Ik ben daar niet.
Be there with your children.
Wees daar met je kinderen.
And when you want to go back home later.
En wanneer je later weer terug naar huis gaat.
You call them.
Dan bel je ze.
I am coming to enjoy.
Ik kom om te genieten.
The fruit of my labor. When are you coming?
Ik heb gewerkt. Wanneer kom je?
Maybe in September I'm there.
Misschien in september ben ik daar.
June.
Juni.
You begin to feel funny in your body.
Begin je een beetje raar te voelen in je.
My head.
Mijn hoofd.
It tends to stroke.
En dan wordt het een beroerte.
So that which you have labored for,
dus dat waar je
you don't enjoy.
But
I read something in Isaiah 62. There's one to tell. He said, hand of labor must live to enjoy. So if today, see women, we have met Jesus and not the accusers who can take away your life, then I'm here to tell you that whatever you have labored for, you shall enjoy. In the name of Jesus. At times I look at myself and I laugh. There are so many things at home.
Er zijn zoveel dingen thuis.
That if I'm not there, they cannot find.
Als ik daar niet ben, dat ze het niet kunnen vinden.
The men that think can be by them.
De mannen, de dingen kunnen
they will still
zijn,
call you.
Zullen je nog steeds bellen?
When you leave, the men can go and go and go.
Als zullen de mannen gaan en gaan en
if
gaan.
If a woman, you change this.
Let op dit.
The moment you leave,
you
said you spent 2 hours.
Twee
and you are 3 hours, more than 2 hours.
Meer dan drie
they start calling you. When they call you, first question they ask, where are you?
Waar ben je?
Okay.
We are forced to take orders and instructions.
En gedwongen om dingen op te nemen van
mensen. So we don't have power.
Dus we hebben geen
kracht. But I want you to compare these two things.
Maar ik wil dat jullie deze
man can accuse you. But if Jesus does not accuse you, then nobody can condemn you. Because he says, neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more. If you walk in righteousness and you walk with God, then God will not condemn us. When your husband is to throw you away, your children are to leave you, the Lord is there to keep you. When people take everything away from you, and you meet Jesus, and people say, go, the Lord is there to take you. That is why I don't want the women here to take the things of God for granted. He has helped me. Back home, I was a professional teacher. Still, we're doing the work of God.
And
that was the main job I was doing.
But that was my
job. When I got sick, I was very vibrant in the school where I teach. When I got sick, they will come there. After 2 weeks, if you don't come, they will come and visit you. After 1 month, if you don't come, they will come and visit you. After 2 months, if you are still sick, then they will tell you, write a letter
om een brief te schrijven
to authorities,
aan de autoriteiten,
to give you pay,
om je te betalen.
What do you call it? Pay without, live with pay, with pay for 3 months. After 6 months,
en na 6 maanden,
then you start to pack your things away.
Dan moet je dingen inpakken.
The very people you have been a blessing to, they become tired of you. They begin to give up on you. So at the end of the day, work time is zero. And then some also sit and say, you don't know this woman. You know what she did. So God is paying her back. People will say because of your sin, that is why you are not married. People will say because of your sin, that is why you don't qualify for anything. But they don't know. There is only one person you can run to. That is Jesus. And when you meet this man I'm talking about, he will not condemn you. He will help you. He will uplift you. He will show you mercy. He will show you favor. And he will announce your favor. Say, I have God.
Amen.
Women, we have to learn to be patient.
Vrouwen moeten geduldig leren zijn.
The woman was quiet.
De vrouw was stil.
When people want to accuse you, you turn this way, they are there. You turn this way, they are there. You turn this way, they are there. You turn this way, they are there.
Kijk naar achter, ze zijn er.
So she was quiet.
Dus ze was stil.
Just imagine the scenario. She was just quiet.
Ze was heel erg stil.
She was down.
Ze was heel erg verdrietig.
In front of the Savior. But I thank God that they did not take that to the fetish priest. I thank God that the people did not take the decision on their own, but decided to take it to Jesus. Today, whatever anybody is doing against you, I speak the blood of Jesus, that God by his power will draw you closer to him and bring their counsel to Lord and bring their thought to Lord so that God will glorify you. The same place where you embarrassed, the same place where people rejected you, the same place where they threw you away, he are going to call you back and God is going to glorify you and say, this is the doing of the Lord and it is marvelous in our sight. Shout, I believe. There are many of us where we live now. If we are to move and they tell us to go back, you will never go. Because everybody is accusing you wrongly. It is not true. But everybody is accusing you wrongly. Some people can go to church. And in the church where you are to seek your salvation, that is the same place. People group. I am from this place. We are from this place. We are from this place. And we are from this place. If you are all from this place, from this place, and I'm one person from Angola, where do I belong? So when I tell I'm not happy, so then I decide to stay home. The Bible says we shouldn't forsake the assembly of the brethren. So if you do that, you are sucking the soul. Women are not supposed to condemn each other. We are supposed to encourage one another. We are supposed to build one another. We are supposed to show love to one another. We are supposed to push one another so that the glory of God will be seen on you. Let me tell you one thing. If you are the type who always destroy people, you don't look beautiful. Maybe you don't know. Don't wait. If you always want to talk about people, look at her legs, look at her stomach, look at her back, look at her fingers. Has it gotten to that? But have you checked yourself? That when you point one finger to somebody, the rest come to you. And the moment you begin to do that, the glory of God begins to depart from you. Try to keep a soul in the church. Always remember, Jesus never condemned. And you are not condemned. When you give woman position in the church, it is very difficult for them to play the role. Because they know when they are coming, somebody will look at their shoe. When they want to climb this, they will make a mistake. Tell somebody, I will do it and do it well. I will make my own mistake. And the Lord will not condemn me. And my mistake will win a soul. And I'm getting somewhere. Say, I believe.
Amen.
They came here, the choir is this. On Wednesday, sacrifice. So if one day something does not go well, can you sing? If you know how to do it better, then join them and teach them. Don't condemn them, because the Savior never came to condemn anybody. Say, I'm not condemned. And nobody can condemn me. If my shoes are nice or they are not nice to you, leave it for me to wear. So far as I feel comfortable in my shoe and the Savior has not condemned me, I love it this way. When my legs are not nice and since I can walk, the Savior has given it to me. Leave me for me to enjoy. When my face is not nice, leave me for me to go. For the Savior has not condemned me. Shout, I believe.
God bless you.
Who told you? If all people were to be short, what would have happened to humanity? If all people were to be slim, what would have happened to humanity? If all people were to be big, what would have happened to humanity? God knows there's a reason why you are you. And nobody can be you. They can learn from you, but nobody can be you. Your uniqueness is taking you somewhere. Your uniqueness is uplifting you. Your uniqueness is taking you to a better place. Say, I am not condemned.
Amen.
Papa.
Amen.
My mother is not your mother.
My mother is not
your mother. Me, my mother, she has never been to school before. But she brought herself very well. The wisdom of my mother, some of you, your mother don't have. Your mother can be in the university. She can do a PhD. But what God has given to my mother, your mother does not have. So I cherish my mother. Because every day my mother tells me that mercy, what I cannot do, you are doing it. And at times I see the traces of my mother's character in me. If you look at my personality, I look like my father. My sister look like my mother. But my mother's humility and her patience is in me. And she looks giddy a little bit like that of my father. And it's a unique way God has prepared us. So I like the way I am. Because God created me for a purpose. And the purpose is what you are seeing. Don't condemn yourself. Jesus never condemned anybody. The moment you accept defeat, you will go down and not go up. Say, I am not condemned. Amen. You walk with your husband, you don't have confidence. You walk with your husband, you see the sleep just passing. Then you say, Ish, Ish, where are you looking at? Turn your face. I won't tell you to turn your face. I am unique. I am fearful. One of the men. What you are seeing, they are not better than me. God knows why he created me. Say, I am alive. Women, be confident. Have the boldness. Jesus never condemned you.
Amen.
What you can do, I cannot do.
What
I can do, you cannot do. If I cannot walk in high heels, and Lucy can walk in high heels, I praise Lucy that you are doing very well. Then she also praise my son Pana, because at the end of the day, we are all lifting the name of God on her. Shout, I believe. Don't come to church and look at people. Hey, look at mommy's clothes. They sewed it well. But look at my back. Then they say, come inside. Say, I'm coming. Come inside, I'm coming. Where are you? Then you be in the bathroom, in the washroom. You check your face, you check your ears, you check your back. Jesus didn't condemn you. You are condemning yourself. So everybody will condemn you. Say, I am not condemned. Amen. You are not condemned.
But
no, as a man thinking in his heart,
so
you see.
So is
high.
So also men's
thinking. But the women, when they walk with the husband, when they see other men, they want them. You want them for what? Cherish your man. I'm telling you, women, we don't have time. Time is very small. As much as you are married, as much as you have children, you have to work on your salvation, like Philippians has been saying. So you don't have time to be checking on people. Today you look better, but tomorrow will be better for me. When somebody saw me on Facebook, said, ah, is that Mercy, the senior girls prefect in our secondary school? I said, yes. I thought you were dead. I got so sick, yes, as pastor. 17 times admission. People thought I would die. But that sickness was for a purpose. Whatever you are going through, God has not condemned you. So don't start condemning yourself. Where I live, if I'm able to move from that place, I think I'll prosper. Who told you? Go and ask Isaac. Where he was being troubled. He was going through problems. But God said, the same place where they are worrying you, the same place, I, the Lord, I will glorify you. Amen. Don't by force yourself to do things you cannot do. My jeep will come. But now I don't have my jeep. Where I'm coming from, you know. You know the Lord, the nature that brought me to church. But you see me. So where you are coming from is not important. Everywhere I'm coming from, you know something. There is a certain lady who came to me. She told me something. She said, Mama, God is wonderful. She came to me and she said, I told her, now remember where you are coming from and always give glory to God. She said she came to Europe, Amsterdam. She made a friend. And every day the friend is telling her, there is an adage in our language. He said, there is an adage. There are two animals. He was always telling the friend that don't compare yourself to this animal.
There's
fish, eh? They are fish.
We don't eat it, but the
other one we eat it. She's telling me that there are two fishes. One is edible, the other one we don't is not edible. But always we have a local something we see there. The idiomatic expression we always speak in our language. That don't compare yourself to the other one. Always the friend was telling her that. She did not understand. And she said she's Pentecostal. So one day she sat down and told the friend that the way you look so beautiful, the way you can post, the way you can riffraff, I am going to Ghana now, I have my document. Can I visit your mother? She said no. She said, why no? We have been friends for 15 years. I want to visit your mother. And then, when the lady got home, she met a friend who came to visit a friend. And he said, when I was coming, I wanted to visit my friend's mother. She said, no, can you give me direction to the place because I want to be a blessing to the woman. Then the friend gave her the direction. A certain village in Kumasi, Ashanti region. She said when she got there, and they stood there, this is the mother of your friend. She was blind, she was crippled, living in a very dirty place. She said, ah, this is not my friend's mother. She told me the mother is living in Makati here, a very beautiful house. And every week she goes to do the health stay in you. This can never be the mother. She said, ah. The friend said, you go ask. She called the mother. The friend said, ah, that is not the friend, my friend's mother. She is a very beautiful lady in Amsterdam, very rich. She said, did she tell you the mother's name? She mentioned an English. She said, that's not the name of the mother. The mother is called Asso. Asso. So she went again, went to the poor woman and asked her, madam, you have a daughter in Europe? Said yes. What is the name? She mentioned the name. But again, the lady was using different name. But the household name they call her was the name the madam used. She said, mama, do you hear from your daughter? She said, never. She's traveled for 15 years. I've never seen her before. I've never heard of her. So what I'm waiting for is I wish I see her one day before I die. The lady cried and cried and cried and cried and said, hey, I have to be content with what I have. Every day she's telling me never to compare myself to her. How can I compare myself to you when your mother is in this state? Why do you cry because of what you have seen? Have you done good research of what you have heard? For all you know, the person you are seeing, that you are belittling yourself. If you are to know the secret behind that person's life, you will give glory to God. Say, I am not condemned. When she came back, she took pictures of the mother. She came to show to her. Is this your mother? At once, you see when something, so the person panics. Panic and says, me? No! She brought a very beautiful woman's picture. The friend says, shame unto you. You are still lying. If you don't take care of your mother, whatever God has given to you, take it away. Some mothers are good. Some too are not good. Some mothers can fast and pray for their children. Some too, because of what they are doing in the realms of their spirit. All they do is they make sure the good thing that comes to you go to the place to sacrifice. But today, whatever the enemy has taken away from you, since Jesus has not condemned you, it will come back to you at once. Because God brought you to Europe for a purpose. And that purpose can never be abused by anybody. Shout, I am alive. We are going to pray for all the women.